Good morning, one and all. Happy Monday. Rush. I'm a big fan of Rush. I have been listening to Rush since about 1975. I discovered Rush through the Caress of Steel album, which doesn't get much love. A lot of bad reviews for that album. I don't know why. It was the first time I had ever heard Rush, was that album. I used to obsess on it, listen to it, put my earphones on, and just jam out to Caress of Steel. So, I thought I'd do The Necromancer. Where are you? There you are. And a lot of people are reacting to, I should say, Rush. And it's all usually the same thing. You know, Tom Sawyer, Red Barchetta, you know the drill. It's pretty much the same thing. So I just wanted to show a little love to Caress of Steel. I've always liked this album. I don't know why it gets a bad rap, but it does. So I'm just going to do the Necromancer and leave it at that, just because. It's a 12-minuter, a slow start, but we will jam out to the Necromancer. Like I said, a bit of a slow start. That's okay.
As gray traces of dawn tints the eastern sky.
I wonder who did this vocal.
The three travelers.
I have a feeling it was Neil Peart who did this.
Fording the river dawn, they turn south, journeying into the dark and forbidding lands of the Necromancer. Even now, the intensity of his dread power can be felt, weakening the body and saddening the heart. Ultimately, they will become empty, mindless specters, stripped of will and soul. Only their thirst.
I can think of some other people
gives them hunger
that are empty, mindless specters. We won't get into that. No, I was just going to say, is this the first album Neil Peart was on? And I always liked getting his voice. I mean, really, who else would you want singing this stuff? And I've always liked the cover of the album. Thought it was one of the cooler covers. That's just me.
Mm-hmm.
kind of like today.
The Necromancer keeps watch with magic through his eyes. He views all his lands and is already aware of the three helpless invaders trapped in his lair.
Oh dear. Nothing worse than being trapped in somebody's lair. Talking much. We're just enjoying this. Stuff. I was hooked on this stuff. Probably why my ears ring today. One of the reasons, anyway. Anyone ever seen them do this live? Well, I saw them. It was like early 80s. I don't know. I've never seen any videos of them doing this. There may be some out there. Don't know. If anyone knows of any, let me know. I'd love to see it.
Enter the champion. Prince Bito appears to battle for freedom from chains of long years. The spell has been broken. The dark lands are
broken. I have thought about doing the Fountain of Lamneth, that whole series of things. That's a 20-minute one. So I chose the shorter one. Definitely in their prime on this album, I think. Geddy was definitely hitting those notes. Heard him lately. Recently. He hasn't got that voice anymore. So much. You know it's him, but you can tell it's harder to do, and that's only natural. Do that for 40 years. Come on. Something's got to give. Ian Anderson, his voice is just not what it used to be at all. The guy in AC/DC. Holy Moses. See, you can be older, and still appreciate this stuff. So I've seen people I knew in my younger days, they just grew out of it, it seems. They didn't care anymore. There was a time they were totally into music, and then it just evaporated for some reason. Not me. Wow, cool. The Necromancer. Well, hang on there, folks. Don't go into the Who's of What's It's here. It's getting ready to jump ahead into the Fountain of Lamneth. I will have to do that at some point. Not today, but I'm going to do something else after I'm done with this one. I think I am anyway. So that was it. Just because I felt like doing something from the Caress of Steel, because Rush doesn't get much more than the usual played. And that's a shame. Alrighty, folks, leave comments. Let me know what you think. And speaking of thinking, I need to figure out what I'm going to do next. Don't know yet, but you'll be the first to know. Later.